SB19 is back, yay! As you all know, they are my own. I'm from the Philippines and this is a Filipino band, so I'm always happy to hear that they have something new. Let's get to it. So SLMT is, it stands for Salamat. One, this is very, very different from all the other songs I've heard from them. This is very stripped down, almost, the intro is actually a percussion, but it's, I guess that's the best term. It's very stripped down. Interesting, I haven't heard the rest of the song, obviously, but I think I'm very, very interested to hear the rest of the song because this is going to be a deviation from how they were progressing as songwriters and as musicians. Their last song really impressed me because it showed me just how they could bend and twist and do something unexpected in every turn and in every line with their songs. But this one is so simple, and I always say this, that a song, if you can play a song with nothing but a guitar and a musician and it still sounds good, you know you have a great song. And so far in the first, just in the opening, I could hear that, like, this is something that you can eventually play and reinterpret and play with nothing but a guitar or nothing but a piano and it's still gonna sound good because the basics are really, really good. Also, I feel like this is going to be some sort of a thank you for 18, maybe a song for them. Let's see. Gratitude for their joining. Also, they're very deglamorized. Very, very simple. And I like that it's all Filipino elements. Many people keep on telling me, like, oh, we need to go to Hawaii, we need to go to the Caribbean because they have the best beaches. And I always say I'm from the Philippines. My expectations are very high. We do have the best beaches in the Philippines. And I've said this before, I'm going to say this again. I do believe that when people talk of paradise, they always talk about the Philippine beaches because we really just have the best. And I like that they've showcased that here. And every element that they're using in every scene is filled with Filipino elements, just elements in our culture. The thing that you saw Stel standing in front of, like this one, that's a traditional Filipino kubo, a bahay kubo. That's our traditional houses during the ancient times when concrete wasn't yet an option in building houses. This is the roof that we used. That is a banana, I think so. That's called a banana leaf. That's what we use for our roof. I like it that they're using all Filipino elements because they've been very much influenced by the West in some of their videos. And this one, they're just going back to the basics. Their clothing, those are filled with very Filipino elements. Liking it so far. Their accessories, those are very Filipino. I think it's a thank you to the 18s and everyone else who helped them in their journey. Like his voice. Even the motorcycle, it's a very popular mode of transportation in the Philippines because of traffic. Traffic in Metro Manila is really bad, and in the provinces, it's very expensive for them to afford a car. So motorcycles, bikes are actually a very it's a very popular mode of transportation. So the mere fact that they incorporated that in, that's a sign that there really is an effort to just display and highlight different Filipino cultural elements. And okay, so the things that are behind him here, this, some of the comics that you're actually seeing behind him, these are some of the popular literary characters that we have, like Dana, that's our version of Wonder Woman. And yeah, so all of that, Liwayway is an old comics, like a graphic novel, a publication for graphic novels. So that's very strong. It plays an important part in our literary history. So nice that they actually made an effort to show all of that. Even their routine is very simple. I think it gives me, the way that I'm doing it right now, actually, they're forcing me to sort of just sit back and listen to what they're saying and enjoy the praises that they're throwing my way, the expression of gratitude, sorry, not praises, but the expression of gratitude. They're just, because everything is so easy, there's nothing really complicated for me to understand. It's just them having fun, them showing the gratitude that they feel. And it's going to seem like it's a very simple song, but gratitude is actually a huge part of our culture. It's more than anything else, we're always taught to look at the brighter side of things, the blessings that we see, because it's highly influenced by our faith. You know, when our faith says that even in your grief, even in your sadness, even in your pain, you have to be thankful, because those have a meaning. It's supposed to stand for something, and you're headed to something bigger. It may be not in this lifetime, but in another lifetime, or another world, or another life. But that's why gratitude is such an important part of our culture, an important part of our personalities as Filipinos. And the mere fact that they've stripped their video and their song, their music, down to its most basics, so that they can just express that, and they're forcing me as an audience to really just enjoy it, shows you just how much of an understanding they have when it comes to our culture and how they can translate that into their music. That's nice. Thank you very much, sir. Ah, they're Palawan. Thank you very much. Palagi mga hobya, di ka nagsasawa. SLMT na buha, mo ba ikaw yung ka? Palagi mga hobya. This part is so good. SLMT na sobra, mahalima, mahal ka na lima. I like it. It's so, I discussed earlier that it may seem like a very simple song, but gratitude is actually a huge part of our culture, and there's a lot of reason for that. As I've said earlier, our faith, because the country is primarily a Catholic country. There's a lot of other religions out there, Protestants and other stuff, you know, Muslims. Buddhist as well. So there's a lot of religions out there, but in many of those religions, gratitude is a huge part of it. We're always taught that whatever it is that's coming our way, there's a bigger purpose for all of that. And so we have to be thankful even in the moments of grief and sadness and difficulties and pain. So when the word thank you, the word salamat, which is our word for thank you, it means a lot to us. It's not something that we just throw away like that. It means something more. It is not just us saying, hey, thank you for passing that bottle of water or that sauce to me. It's a state of our being. Gratitude is a state of our being. So this means something more. Again, I like that they stripped everything down to its simplest form, so that I am able, as an 18 and as a Filipino, I'm just able to concentrate on what they're saying. And that is them saying thank you, which is, again, an important part of our culture. Third, I did like when he said in the song, he says, Mahal ka na lima, which is there are five guys who love you here. And don't ever forget that. And so we always consider success for us, part of her success is being able to affect other people's lives. So for us to say, for someone that we idolize and we admire, telling us that we are grateful for you because you brought us here and there are five guys who love you, that's an affirmation. They're telling us, they're validating our efforts, and that our efforts did something for them, for their success. So that's the song, in other words, is more than just a thank you to everybody. This is an affirmation of our culture as Filipinos. I like it. And then I think they shot in Palawan. If you've ever made it to the Philippines, don't forget to visit Palawan. Palawan there's two popular destinations in the Philippines, two of the many. One is Boracay and one is Palawan. If you like partying and stuff, in one of the best sand in the world, you go to Boracay. But if you want some relaxation and some interaction with nature and water, then you go to Palawan. There's a place there where you can actually swim with the whales. Of course, they don't harm you. The butandings, the whales. There's a season where you can go there and you can swim with the whales. And it's life-changing. Being able to touch a whale is what life-changing. You can feed the fish, you can bring bread, and the fish will feed off your hand. So Palawan, if they actually shot in Palawan, it's a good choice because it's away from the partying of Boracay. Palawan is when you actually interact with Philippines, with what the Philippines can offer in terms of nature. Great song. They did a very good job in being able to reflect and demonstrate a really, really strong part of our culture in such a simple way. And looking forward to more.